Welcome to this brief guide on how to share video in Microsoft Teams without lag. You find yourself in that Teams call and someone is presenting the deck that they've embedded a couple of videos on, and there are invariably going to be people on the call who are complaining of dropped frames or laggy audio, or absolutely worse, no audio at all. Today I'm going to show you how to use PowerPoint Live to prevent that from happening in future. You'll notice I have slides 2 and 3, which are currently blank. I'm gonna add some video content there. And slide 4, where I've actually embedded a locally saved video file from my PC. For slide 2, I'm gonna select the Insert tab in the ribbon. We're gonna scroll right over to the end of the ribbon there, and we're gonna select Video, and then select the option for Stock Videos. This will give us a selection of stock videos that we can choose from. I'm actually gonna just select New to filter it out, and we'll try and find something that's quite nice with a little bit of motion. There we go, a lovely little babbling brook. Now I select that particular video and click Insert. It'll take a couple of moments depending on your internet connection to download the video from the server, but once done, it'll be inserted into your slide and you'll have design ideas just like normal. I'll just quickly select an option. I also have the ability to select play and actually check to make sure that the video is the correct video for my deck and that it's running smoothly. For slide 3, I'm going to hit Insert, then Video, and this time I'll select Online Videos. This will give me a pop-up that lets me know that I have a swath of applications that I can share videos from, including YouTube, Vimeo, Stream, Flipgrid. In this case, I have a video on Vimeo that I'm going to share, and I'm just going to copy the URL for this video. And once I've got my video URL copied, in PowerPoint, I just paste it into the search box here. And PowerPoint's going to give me a quick preview of the video that I have linked to, just to make sure that it is the correct video. I can hit play if I'd like to verify this and play the video. I know it's the correct one, so I'm just going to hit insert. Now, it'll take a couple of moments to embed the video from Vimeo into your PowerPoint deck, but once done, it'll appear, and just like normal, we have design ideas, so I'm going to select one to make the video a little bit larger. Now, before sharing this to the Teams call, I need to make sure that my deck is completely saved and preferably in OneDrive for Business or SharePoint. This prevents me from needing to do a long upload afterwards when I join the Teams call. So I'll join my Teams call, and in the top corner here you'll see surrounded by red is my attendees video feed and surrounded by purple is my video feed. I now want to share my deck, so I hit share, but instead of selecting the window for my presentation, I scroll down to the PowerPoint Live option and select the deck from there. What this will do is make sure that my deck is uploaded to the call itself so that both myself and the attendees get a lag-free video experience, no matter where they are. Now to showcase this, there's my babbling brook, and what you'll notice on my attendees video feed, he's currently got a very, very smooth video. I've also then now jumped across to the live video, and when I click play, what'll happen is it will buffer locally for each user on their own device. As you can see, the attendee has got a smooth video. Yes, he's a second or two behind me at the moment, but if I was to jump through the video, because it's buffered on his end as well now, it catches him up right to where I am as well. The benefit here is that I also know that the audio is playing locally on their own device, so they won't have any dropped audio in any way, as well as no dropped frames. Now, the benefit of this is that it's no longer needing to download the video to my machine, then upload it to the Teams call, then download it to their device. Because it's playing directly from the actual Teams call itself, it minimizes the number of jumps that the video needs to make. As a result, it ensures that each user gets a smooth video experience without having any dropped frames or potentially any delays or lags in the audio as well. As you can see in this video, the video feed is nice and smooth across the board. It's also worth noting that my attendee in this instance is utilizing the desktop client for Microsoft Teams, but this experience would be the same whether they were on the web or on mobile devices as well. And that is how you use PowerPoint Live in Microsoft Teams to correctly share a video for a lag-free experience for all. I hope you found this tip extremely useful. Feel free to share this video out to all of your colleagues and just make those Teams meetings in the future just a little bit nicer for everyone. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.